So finally I've reached Aachen Hauptbahnhof. I have some students here who are here to pick me up. They are currently studying here in the University of RWTH Aachen. Why don't you just tell us like quickly what are you studying exactly?
I'm studying Production Systems Engineering and I'm here from 6 months.
So I am studying MSc in Management and Engineering. I'm here from 6 months.
Yeah, I'm also studying Management and Engineering. It's been 6 months.
So yeah, I'm also studying with them. They are my classmates. We are doing it.
Very quickly, before we start our campus tour, which are the famous hostel or accommodation services here where a lot of students go and stay?
We have for student and work, there is a dormitory called Kastanian Veg. And I am residing in Kastanian Veg for the past 3 months.
Okay.
And I would say in the initial stages it's a bit harder to get, but once you get in then it becomes very smooth to live here.
Are you guys also staying in the same?
Yeah, I do live in Kastanian Veg.
Okay.
But the thing is, like, I got it through the International Academy lottery, but if you want to go there with the application and all, it almost takes around 6 months in waiting list.
Six months.
So I'll recommend that you apply before you get here.
And apart from Kastanian Veg, there is also one at Chillers Lhasa called the Towers. There are four towers. They are the closest to the proximity of city center, and it's very convenient to get a hostel.
Super C building, and the purpose of this building is the most important one. So come to the building, I'll tell you.
So as soon as you arrive here, what is the place? This place is called as what?
It's known as Temple Graben.
Temple Graben.
Yes.
So how can someone reach here? What is the nearest
there's a bus stop, Technische Hochschule.
So it's the name of the bus stop.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. There's also a bus stop over there. It's Bischofsgässchen.
This Super C building, this is where you come on the very first day, as he said, and make sure that on the way to Germany you're carrying all your original documents, but I guess that's the process, right?
Yes.
There's something called enrollment here. Every university, no matter which part of Germany you go, there is a process on day one itself. It's called as enrollment, where they will cross-verify all the original documents. That's the purpose. Is this what you did?
Yes, that's what I also did. I bought all the documents and I came here. This is the main building for us. And I took it and got it enrolled.
What
all the documents.
Other works do you get done here?
And the next thing is that this building also has a visa extension center, where we, again, after the city registration, we come over here and get our visa extension done as well.
This is such an amazing service, because in Berlin, where I live, we have to go to foreign office, especially to get this thing done. And here, they're getting everything done here, right here in one building itself. What about student ID card?
Student ID card, after you register over here, I think after 1 week or something, we have to collect the student ID card, which is also, again, it is in the basement of this building.
The same building?
In the same building. So, it's a one-stop solution for all of your needs.
Right. So after this Super C, we are heading towards the library section there. There are two or three buildings here. Literally every other building here in Aachen belongs to this university, RWTH. He said something. He was saying that jidhar bhi patthar phekoge pure city mein RWTH ke building pe hi girega. What about cost of living in a month here?
If you're staying in student hostel, then it would be like around 300. You can manage everything. But if you are staying in a your own apartment, then it would come around 400 to 450. So it's considerably cheaper than other cities. But yeah, that's how the cost is here.
Like the food included, or?
Including the food, I am saying it can come around between, it varies from 300 to 450. So something like that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. That may, you don't seem convincing with that.
Because like, for me it's around 500.
500, right.
I live in a student hostel.
Right. What's your rent?
I'm paying 350, including electricity and internet charges, everything.
But I'm also asking about the food and stuff.
So including food, it will come to around 500 for me.
550
to 500. So it depends on what you're going to eat. I am basically eat vegetarian food. So it comes around 450. You add another 50, so it would be 500.
Good. Let's move forward.
So we have come here to the libraries. There are in all three libraries at the Avetiha, and this one is known as the Semi 90 building. It is the language center, as well as there are study rooms in the building, and that over there is the main library building. You can borrow the books. Also, there are study places and lockers over there, and it's open throughout the week, but the timings may vary.
Okay, what about that?
That's also a library.
So there are three libraries in just proximity of like, what, I don't know, about 100 meters.
Yeah.
There's one here, there's one here, there's right behind us. Good. Where are we going next?
We are going to the main building of Avetiha. That's the Hauptgebäude.
Okay, let's go.
What is this building?
This is the one of the important building. It's called Hauptgebäude. This is the oldest building in Avetiha Jharkhand. None of the classes are held. Most of the classes are held in the other places.
Yeah.
But here still there are quite a few classes are held, and also a couple of student like film showing competition or some student work will be held over here. This was constructed in 1870. Now RWT is celebrating 150 years. So a couple of events are going to be held in this particular place.
Right, right.
So along with what you said, there's a building right opposite to the main building. It's where we give our exams.
Yes, even I have given exam over here. So we had a couple of exams. There is a basement area over there, and there are very good examination halls where we go and write the exams. That's pretty important building for most of the students.
Yeah.
Okay, so usually roads are not this empty. I'm here on Sunday, that's why everything is dreaded. There's no one on the streets. However, where are we going next?
So we are going to see where exactly we can get a photocopies, and also we will show you where you can get a good coffee over here at a very cheap price.
Let's go. 13A is the bus which will get you here at Technische Hochschule. This is the bus stop.
So this is the Copy 2000 shop, and this is where you take your copies, printouts, and you can get it as cheap as 5 cents per copy.
5 cents?
Yeah.
And you must be having a student card by which you can get the printout. Do you have some provisions like that?
So that is for the library. That is for the library, but since it is very cheap, like 5 cents or 10 cents at the max, hardly anybody has a printer at their home, because you know in Germany, cartridge cost is more expensive than the printer.
Yeah, that's true.
So that's the reason why most of the people prefer to come over here and take a couple of printouts rather than having a printer at home.
Right. I mean, it depends on how much use you have for the printer, right?
To be honest, yeah.
Right. Let's just walk. There's a shop right next to this place. This is where they buy beverages. Pretty cheap. Cheap as in like quite affordable. So, what is this?
Frankenheim.
This is a Frankenheim.
This is a stationery shop basically.
Okay.
And we get a very good cheap coffee as well for 50 cents. And that's very good.
It's very important to talk about coffee. They're showing the whole shop where they sell other stuff also, which is their main business.
Right behind me is the Kuss curve, and it is believed that whoever passes underneath this curve, and he's gonna fail the exams. So it's a superstition over here.
So during the exams, make sure that you don't pass through this curve. That's just a superstitious belief in Aachen.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
So shall we go through the curve, or shall we go to the other side of the curve?
You guys have exam. These guys have exam in next 2 or 3 days.
So let's not take that risk.
Like, why don't you go through?
What we see till now was the other areas of the Super C. As you can see, we are standing behind the Super C. Now we will walk towards another couple of important buildings over here. As you can see, there are RWTH buildings. That one is also RWTH. This is also RWTH building. So going forward, I will keep showing you all the RWTH buildings over here in the nearby area.
So we are now at the Audi Mac, and this is the building where we had our orientation. That's the first day, and the introduction session was organized in this building. And also some of our lectures take place over here. So we are now at CAL, that is Central Auditorium for Research and Learning. And this is the biggest auditorium at Avetiha Aachen. We have most of our classes over here as well.
one what we saw was a super sea area. This is called Temple Gravel, and this is called as Campus Malata.
Okay.
And there is one more campus over there, which is called
Campus Boulevard.
Campus Boulevard. Four basically: Kakastasa, Campus Malata, Campus Boulevard, and the Temple Gravel one.
That's where we were just now, right?
Yes, we were in Temple Gravel. Now we have come to Campus Malata.
So let's move forward.
Yeah.
So we are now at the Campus Boulevard campus of the RWTH Aachen, and in this building there are like three main parts. The first one is International Office, second one is the WZL Laboratory for Machine Tools, and the third one is Business School.
So for us, most of the classes are held in this particular building.
Mm-hmm.
We have like strategy management, marketing as a part of a business school. We come over here and study. Along with our class studies as well, here we have got an international office as well. But this is a bit different from what we see in the Super C building. Some of the functionalities are held here. But mostly we use the Super C building for all the administrative related works for international students.